Welcome! Choose your learning buddy. Let's review the numbers one more time. How many cats are there? Count the number of objects and write your answer inside the box.
Hello everyone! It's me, Teacher Jelly. Ang inyong teacherelang lingkod! And I'm back for another video tutorial. In this video, I'll be showing you how you can create engaging lesson games by just using your PowerPoint presentation. By the way, if you have not joined our giveaway, just click the giveaway post link in the description box and it will direct you to the Facebook post. We are giving away 3 clip-on lapel microphones that you can use for your teaching and learning needs. The giveaway is open for all students and teachers. So hurry now and join! As you can see, simple as it seems, PowerPoint presentation can be a very powerful tool for classroom and online instruction.
First of all, I want to show you the finished product. So this is the PowerPoint presentation that I made yesterday. Welcome! Choose your learning buddy. As you have seen, students have the freedom to choose a character who will serve as their learning buddy all throughout the PowerPoint presentation. I decided to make and include 3 learning levels where in each level they have to accomplish a certain task. In this part, naisip ko na mag-include ng video song na tungkol sa counting numbers. Unfortunately, I cannot show you the entire video song dahil copyrighted siya. Galing siya sa isang channel for kids. The good thing about this is students can play the song, can play the video even without internet connection dahil naka-embed na yung video doon sa PowerPoint file. Let's review the numbers one more time. Mamaya po, ituturo ko sa inyo kung paano gawin yung may automatic narration.
1. Say 1. Sabihin mo, 1. 1. 2. 2. Say, 2. Sabihin mo, 2.
And I did the same thing for the rest of the numbers hanggang number 10. So, lahat po yan ay merong audio na pwede nyong i-click at pwedeng mapakinggan ng student. By the way, mali ako dun sa number 10 kasi kulang yung penguin. 8 lang yung penguin, dapat 10 yan. Sorry.
10. 10.
Great job! You did well on level 1. Here's your badge.
Yes, may pa-badge si teacher.
How many cats are there?
Mm.
How many balls are there? How many tomatoes are there? Amazing! Another badge for a job well done. Count the number of objects and write your answer inside the box.
Sa mga hindi po nakakaalam dyan, meron po tayong pen tool sa PowerPoint presentation. So mamaya papakita ko kung paano nyo magagamit yon, kung paano magagamit ni student.
Count the number of objects and write your answer inside the box. Count the number of objects and write your answer inside the box. Count the number of objects and write your answer inside the box. Count the number of objects and write your answer inside the box. Excellent! Keep up the great work!
Natapos na ni student ang 3 levels.
Congratulations! We were able to finish the 3 game levels together! I am so happy! Show your family what you learned. Count the number of the following objects inside your house. Plates, chairs, curtains, and hangers.
There! Natapos na ni student laruin ang ating interactive game using PowerPoint presentation. By the way, teachers, in making interactive games like this one, we have to make sure na yung gagawin natin ay naka-align sa kung ano bang objective natin para sa mga bata. Like in this one, ang lesson na ginawan ko ay for pre-kinder, kinder to grade 1, yung counting from 1 to 10. Pero hindi po talaga ako nagtuturo ng ganitong lessons. What I taught before are lessons for secondary level, but I found this really fun to do. Now, proceed na tayo doon sa features ng PowerPoint presentation na ginamit ko sa paggawa nitong interactive game na to. So, here are the 4 things that I'm gonna talk about for the next few minutes. Number 1, I'm gonna talk about hyperlink. Number 2, voice over narration. Number 3, automatic animations. And 4, yung pen tool. Madaling-madali lang yon, alright? Okay, let's begin with the use of hyperlink. Yung hyperlink po, ayun po yung ginamit ko doon sa mga part na kung saan kapag kinlik mo yung isang shape or yung isang picture doon sa PowerPoint, nagdadirect siya to another slide. Like this one, if I press here, pag kinlik ko yung press here, it will direct me to another slide. Also, dito rin, no, kapag pumili ako ng body, it will direct me to another slide. Like this. Kunwari, pili natin si Kim. Diba? Napunta siya dito sa slide na to. So, let's say I wanna go back. And si Jade na lang gusto kong piliin. It directed me again to another slide. So, that is the power of hyperlink. And it's very easy to do. Pakita ko sa inyo. Let's say, click natin tong picture na to ni Jade. Right click. Makikita mo dyan yung option na hyperlink. Okay, any object in your PowerPoint, you can click that and put a hyperlink. So, let's say ito, kunwari, itong bubble, speech bubble na to. right click, kita nyo may hyperlink. Ibig sabihin, pag naglagay ka ng hyperlink, kapag hindi kitong object na to, madadirect sa another slide. Okay, hyperlink, it's linking the slides. I have a thorough and separate video just for hyperlink. Matagal ko na pong nagawa yan. Ito po yun. Ayan. Paano gumamit ng hyperlink? It's an easy tutorial. And I want you to just watch that video. I'll be putting the link of that video in the description box below para mas mabilis tayo. Hindi na humaba itong video na to. Next, let's talk about voice over or yung tinatawag nating narration. Okay, say I want to record this line. Gusto ko sasabihin siya. Ganyan. Gusto ko naka-narrate na siya. Now, I want you to go to Insert. Yan, yung Insert tab, katabi ng Home. Punta ka dito sa Audio. Insert Audio. Click mo yung down arrow. Click Record Audio. Ayan, tapos may lalabas na ganitong box. So, dito na tayo magre-record. Just click this red dot. Pag na-click mo na yan, you can now start recording. Let's try. Let us work together in finishing this game. And then, kapag tapos ka na, press mo lang to stop. And then, okay. Ngayon, nakita mo may lumabas na audio icon. Ibig sabihin, successful tayong nakapag-record ng ating narration. Ngayon, itry natin kung maayos ba nating na-record. Let us work together in finishing this game. And then, kapag tapos ka na, press mo lang to stop. Ayan, yes. Ngayon, you are free to put this anywhere in your slide. Ngayon, Teacher Jelly, next question. How do we do an automatic narration or yung automatic voiceover? Yung kapag pumunta ka na dun sa slide na yon, automatic nang magpe-play yung narration. No need to press play. Ganyan. Pag click mo tong audio icon, dito sa taas may lalabas na format and playback. Audio tools yan. Okay, ulitin natin. Click natin tong audio icon natin. May lumabas sa taas. Format and playback. I want you to click playback. Ayan, makikita natin itong mga choices na to and options and settings. Now, if you want to do an automatic narration, select automatically. Okay, ito kasi may dalawang option. Start on click, ibig sabihin, i-click mo pa bago mag-play. Or, start automatically. Dahil gusto natin automatic, pipiliin natin automatically. Okay? Say masyadong napahaba yung dead air mo doon pala sa audio na na-record mo. You can simply trim your audio. Click this. At lalabas yung audio file kanina. So, makikita mo doon sa unahan, no? Medyo flat line. Ibig sabihin, iyon yung part na wala ka pang sinasabi. So, piliin lang natin to. Ibig sabihin, doon na siya mag-i-start. Kung nasaan yung green line, doon siya mag-i-start. Okay? And you're good. Alright? As simple as that. Let's repeat. Insert tab. Audio. Record audio. Red dot. Okay? And it's done. Yay! Now, on the third one, we're gonna talk about the automatic animation. So, gusto mo na yung animation mo ay automatic nang nag-a-appear or gumagalaw even without pressing next. Yung ganon. Hindi mo na kailangan i-click just for a certain object or text to move. So, for example, dito sa slide na to, you want this text, tong Let's Play, to move. Even without you clicking it. Pag-click mo dyan sa text na yan, go to Animations tab. Ito sa taas. Animations. And there you will see lots of animations. Click drop-down arrow. More animations here. So, for example, I want to use the fly-in na animation. Click ko lang yan. there. Nakita niyo yung preview. Let's check if that worked. May nagpupukpok sa kabilang bahay. Sorry. Diba hindi? Kailangan ko pa siyang i-press. Ayun. Let's make it automatic. Click it again. And you will see animation pane. Click animation pane. There you will see sa right side, may box dyan. Click mo to, drop down, and select start after previous. Kapag ito ang pinili mo, no need to press next. May no need to press any button just for it to be animated. Ayan, let's try if that worked. There. There. It already has an automatic animation. So, let's try naman dito sa mga pictures. Itong object na to, I clicked it. And then, I will choose the animation that I want. Let's say I want bounce. And I want it also to be automatic animation. I will click this and start after previous. Let's try one more time. See? See, no need to press any button. Automatic na siya. It will play after the previous animation that you did. So, as simple as that. Last one, we're gonna talk about pen tool. So, ito yung pinakita ko kanina. So, I included this pen tool dun sa last level ng aking presentation game. So, let's say here, my instruction was for the student or for the kid to write his or her answer inside the box. So, how are they gonna do that? Over here, meron tayong mga icons sa baba. And I want you to focus on the third icon. Ayun yung pen icon. When you click that, there will be other options. First option is the laser pointer. So, if parent ka and you wanna guide your student in reading, gusto mong ma-focus yung student sa kung anong object or text ang meron sa PowerPoint, you can use this. Same as, you know, teachers can also use that one. And next one is the pen. Ito yung ginamit ko. So, students can write using the pen. And they can also write using a highlighter. It's up to you. If you want a thicker line, you can use a highlighter. Next, we have the eraser. Very important too. Ayan, kung nagkamali yung student, they can erase what they have written and write the correct one. And last, we have erase all ink on the side. Lahat ng mga din-drawing mo, you can erase that with just one click. And also, you have here variations of colors for your pencil and highlighter. There you go, and we are done with the four features that I used with my PowerPoint presentation interactive game. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If you did, please do not forget to share this with your friends, co-teachers, co-parents, and admins. Also, feel free to comment down in the section box below your suggested topics for my next video.
Do not forget to share this video with your friends, school admins, and co-teachers. I'll see you again on my next video. Bye-bye!